Ladies and gentlemen of the jury are seated. Do you promise to follow the law and be fair to everyone?
I do.
Very well. Then at this time, we are ready for the opening statements of counsel.
Beaten in an army.
cross-examination. Morning, what's your name? Good morning. All right, you may proceed.
Was Goldilocks scared when she awoke?
Yes.
What time did you get back?
Around 6:30.
Did you leave the door open?
No.
That's all your problem.
All right, thank you. You may step down now. All right, people's next witness.
My name is Tammy.
Morning. Who are you calling as a witness? All right, if you'd be able to come forward, please. Raise your right hand. Do you promise to tell the truth?
Yes.
Thank you. Be seated.
What is your name?
You, David.
Who was sleeping in your bed?
A strange girl.
Did you feel scared that someone broke into your room?
No.
How did you feel when you saw the broken chair?
I was sad.
Did the strange girl in the room? Where is she?
She is sitting next to the girl, the lady, in the room.
Please identify that.
The record will still reflect. Cross examination? What's your name? What's your name?
My name is Sarah.
Good morning.
I want to ask you for some questions.
All right, you may.
Did you see Goldilocks eating her your food? Did you see her break your chair?
No.
Did you see her break it inside your house?
No.
Did you show her your teeth?
Oh, baby, I don't have any teeth.
You may step down. People's next witness.
Morning, Brian.
Morning, Brian. Who are you calling?
Officer Simone.
Were you in the forest the day in question?
No.
What animals did you see?
The chair was broken.
Which one of the three bears reported the crime to you?
Polar bear.
What is your expert opinion about who committed this crime?
Goldilocks.
Thank you. Cross-examination? All right.
Who reported the crime?
Papa Bear.
What did you see when you got there?
Broken chair.
In your expert opinion, who was the crime?
Goldilocks.
Great. You may stand and cross you. Thank you.
My name is Jeremy.
Morning, Jeremy. Who are you calling?
Mr. Adam.
My relation with the victims is that Mama Bear, Papa Bear, and Baby Bear come to Mrs. Abby's store every day.
How long have they been Miss Abby's customers?
For a while.
How did the bears get along with their her customers?
The bears get along with the other customers. By buying a lot of stuff.
All right, cross-examination. Morning, what's your name?
Good.
That's right, you're right.
How long have you known the bears?
For a while.
Are the bears honest and trustworthy?
Yes.
Have they ever cheated you?
No.
Just on your honor.
All right, you may step down. Thank you. Any further witnesses for the people?
No further witnesses.
Have rested. Ladies and gentlemen, the jury, the defense may present evidence at this time if they wish to, but they're not required to. Does the defense wish to call any witnesses?
I would like to call Goldilocks.
You have a right to remain silent. Do you want to testify anyway?
Yes.
Okay, please proceed.
My name is Raphael.
Morning.
What's your name?
Goldilocks.
Can you describe the weather that day before you called?
Yes.
When did you enter the cabin?
Because I was lost.
How did you get in?
By opening the door.
What happened when the bears awoke you with a big growl?
I got startled and ran away.
Are you sorry that you injured?
Yes.
Cross-examination?
No. How did you enter the house? By opening in the door.
Why did you eat the porridge?
Because I was hungry.
Why did you sit in the chair and lay in the bed?
Because I was tired.
Did you have permission to go in the house?
No.
Did you have permission to use the porridge?
No.
Do you have permission to sit on the chair and sleep on the bed?
No.
Please step down. Any other witnesses for the defendant?
That's it.
Okay, defense has rested. At this time, then, we're ready for the closing arguments of counsel.
Your Honor, we have shown that Goldilocks without being invited walked to the first home and ate Baby Bear's porridge and broke Baby Bear's chair and slept in his bed. She did all this without permission, so he is guilty. Even though Goldilocks is impaired, that is no excuse. I'm sure that the jury agrees that a person who displays good manners does not do such things. Our evidence proves that she is guilty of all crimes. Thank you.
Your Honor, we have shown that Goldilocks is a good girl. No harm in going. She has said that she meant no harm in going to the house and the door was open. She was lost and hungry, so when she saw the porridge, she ate so she'd feel better. There is no evidence she broke Baby's Bear's chair. She is not big enough to have broken it. I think the chair was broken when she sat in. She is sorry she slept in the bed, but she was so exhausted she needed a place to rest. She is innocent and my has been brought against her. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the evidence is complete and you've heard the closing arguments of counsel. At this time, you may begin your deliberations.
The state of Colorado versus Goldilocks. On count one, we find the defendant guilty of the charge of breaking and entering. On count two, we find the defendant not guilty of the charge of criminal mischief. On count three, we find the defendant not guilty of the charge of theft.
Very well, thank you very much for your service. It's important that people come forward and as citizens and play a role as a juror. What you do is very important and I appreciate you doing it here today. With that, I believe the trial is concluded.
Thank you
all for your very fine work.